In the previous video, we saw that it's a fairly straightforward process to be able to write data to a file from a PHP script. Part of what makes the process so straightforward is the fact that there's really one main function in PHP that's used for writing data, the fwrite function. Reading data from a file in PHP, on the other hand, is a very different story. It's not that reading data is necessarily a more complicated process than writing data was. What's different is that in PHP there are a wide variety of different functions that can be used for reading data depending on the exact situation. In this video, what I want to do is take a look at one of several different functions that we'll use in PHP to read data. The function I want to look at in this one is called the fgets function. So what I'm going to do here is I basically have a file set up, a script started, as I've done previously. The file's name is fgets read colors. We'll do other examples, basically the same thing again in the future with some other functions, but for this one, this is where I'm starting, and what I'd like to do is essentially just read colors out of the colors file that I created, one line at a time. Each one of those lines of colors that I read, what I want to do is display it in an unordered list. So let me start here in the body of my document by creating an unordered list. There we are. Inside the unordered list then, at some point I'm going to need to actually open the file. It would probably make more sense to go ahead and do that up above my document. I'll go through the same basic process to open our file as we've done previously. The name of my file is colors.txt. And I'm going to open the file in read mode with the R. Then I'll go on and make sure that the file's actually opened like we've done before. There we are. That should get us started. What I need to do in this case, though, is I need to decide what happens if for some reason I'm not able to actually open the file. There's a number of different ways we could go. I could potentially move this code down into the body, use this if-else statement to decide whether data from the file will be displayed or whether I want to display some other message or not. But I really like to try and keep this as separated from the HTML code as I can. I'd rather not have my HTML code in a gigantic if-else with all this extra stuff if I can avoid it. So I think maybe what I'll do is I'll create an errors variable like I've done previously. Not really an errors variable, more of an errors array. And if I'm going to say if I wasn't able to open the file, then I will push into that array an error message. Then I could check for the size of that errors array down below and use that to decide whether to display the unordered list or if I want to display some other error message. So let me do this. I'm going to say if the count of the errors array, I'm going to say if it's equal to 0, then I want to go on and do the work I was planning here with the unordered list. Otherwise, I can just show my error message. So I think I'll just put in a paragraph and I'll say the file could not be opened, which I guess I've already typed once. I could have just shown the value from the errors array, but I suppose this will probably work just as well too. So one way or another, that gets my file open. It sets up how to handle it if the file can't be open for whatever reason. One other thing I might throw in here is after I actually do display my list, I'm going to close the file. Closing the file is not nearly as important when we're reading from it as when we're writing to it, but it certainly doesn't do any harm to go ahead and make sure that the file does get closed when we're done. All right, with all that legwork out of the way, then I'm kind of back in a way where I started wanting to read lines out of the file in order to create this unordered list. What I can do here is this is where the fgets statement can come in. The fgets function that we can use in PHP allows us to read data from a file. When we call the function, we need to specify what file we want to read from. And what the fgets function will then do for us is it will read a single line from the file and return that line. So let me store the return value from that function in a variable. Once I've actually read a line from the file, I can then do whatever it is that I want to do with it. I could, for example, echo. I'm going to echo out a list item, and inside that list item, I'm going to put in the value of my line variable, a bit like that. That's a good place for us to start. That certainly won't be complete, but let's take a look in the browser and see how that actually looks. So here in the browser, if I go ahead and refresh my script, that's what I actually end up with. This is the first color from my file. The color's name is Billy's Chinos, and its red, green, and blue value are DD, E0, and CF. So I read out that one line just fine. That is the first line from the file. Here, let me let you take a look at that file. This is what's actually in my file, so you'll kind of know what data we're working with. And you see the first line there is what was actually just read from the file, so that actually seemed to work just fine. Why did it only read one line? Well, one line was all I asked it to read. All right, if I wanted it to read another line, then what I could of course do is I could call the fgets statement again. So if I were to copy and paste and read another line in using fgets, take a look at that in the browser, you can see now I've read the second line from the file. So everything looks like it's working fine. The problem is, how many times do I need to call fgets? Well, as you can imagine, it would depend on how many lines there are in my file, and that is bound to change. There may be less lines at certain times, there may be more lines. I never know exactly how many lines there may be. So calling fgets manually like this isn't really going to help me much. What I want to do instead is I want to call fgets, but I want to do it from inside a loop. For this particular purpose, a while loop will work well. The question with a while loop then becomes, what do we use as our condition? Well, what we can do is that PHP provides us with a special function that we can use to detect when we're at the end of the file. The function is called FEOF. So for a file, are we at the end of file? We pass that function the file that we're working with, and what will happen is the FEOF function will return to us true or false, letting us know whether we are at the end of the file or not. So we can say while we're not at the end of the file, continue reading lines and outputting those lines. If I jump back over to my browser and take a look at how that works, that's what I actually end up with. Overall, things look pretty well. If we again compare that to the actual data in the file, here's the file. Right? You can see the first color in the file is Billy's Chinos, the last one is Blue Jay White, and it looks like that's exactly what actually came out in the browser. So that seems to have worked just fine and dandy. A few little things about this though. First of all, you notice that there's one extra bullet there at the end. That one extra bullet comes from the fact that our file actually has a blank line at the end of it. That blank line is caused by the fact that we have a new line character that we write out at the end of each one of our colors. The script that we created in the previous video in the previous example explicitly puts a new line character in the file every time it writes out a new set of data fields for a color. The result of that is that we always end up with a blank line at the bottom. There are different ways we could potentially handle that. We could change the way that the data is written to the file, where we put the new line at the beginning, but if we did that, we would just have a blank on the first line. We could try to detect whether there was already a blank and decide whether we should put it or not. It would all get really, really complicated. What would actually be much simpler would be to just filter out that blank line on the end when we're reading it. Here, if I jump back to my editor, what I could do is I could just check the value of the line variable and decide if it's empty, don't show it, don't use it. So here I'll just take the echo statement where we're printing out the value of the line variable, and I'll check to see if it's empty. I can do that easily enough with the empty function. So if the line variable is empty, show it. No, we need to say if the line variable is not empty, show it. With that little addition, if I take a look at it in my browser again, refresh, you can see that that extra bullet we had at the bottom caused by the blank line disappears. Now we're only outputting lines that actually have content, no empty lines. Overall, I would say that was actually the smallest problem we have. The larger problem that we have here using fgets is, what if I wanted to do something more constructive with this actual data rather than just printing it out line by line? What if I wanted to, for example, create a table where the name of the color was in one column, the red value another column, green another column, blue another. The way things are set up right now, where I'm simply reading in each line from the file as one total and complete line, basically makes that, I hesitate to use the word impossible, but it's definitely impractical from where we stand right now. Later in the course, we will learn some different string functions that will make it fairly easy for us to be able to take something like our line variable that contains multiple fields and to be able to split that up so that we could do something like display these color parts in different columns of a table. But from where we stand right now, we don't yet have any file input functions, file reading functions that let us read more than less than an entire line at a time. And we also at this point don't have any string functions that let us do anything with these monolithic strings that we're reading. So this is kind of where we have to stop with fgets. It can potentially be useful, but it does run into a limit of what you can do with it when you're dealing with reading lines from a file that have multiple fields delimited in them. What we'll do in some of the future videos is we'll take a look at some different file reading functions that PHP provides us that will let us overcome this particular limitation.